brand called Decolonize. We are working with Paul. He's going to tell us everything about the new line. So Paul, please tell us more about Decolonize.
Okay, so I'm going to start with what Decolonize means, right? So for the longest time, we have been living under colonization. The whole system to how things are happening currently. So we see our brand as an instrument to change and the change we want to make. So we spread the message by creating products that are really good looking to everybody, but also have a social message behind it, because at the end of the day, our struggle, we believe the struggle as the young generation is to basically get back everything that was taken from us by the people that colonized our nations in Africa as a whole. So this is just like, you see with the whole gang, right? We wanted to create a system that would bring people together. So we dropped gang. So gang was just to unite everyone and get them into like a, I mean like a box and say, yo guys, these are the people that we want to communicate with and have all these ideas. And these people can tell all their friends and their friends can tell all their friends. So with gang, we had a big pool of people buying into the whole idea of gang. You know what I mean? And we moved from gang, now that we have the unity of the people, we started preaching the message, which is black supremacy. You know what I mean? Like what it means, you know? What exactly black supremacy is. And it also got people that endorsed it, like we went a level higher than what gang did for us with black supremacy. Right? So we feel like with Decolonize, it's more of a straight to the point message. We're not hiding anything, we're not saying, you know, fuck white supremacy or whatever the case might be. All we're saying is that as the young people, as responsible citizens of the next generation, we are starting to think, you know, of ways to help strengthen us as a black society, as upcoming young people. So with Decolonize, we're preaching messages of saying, you know, we're spying to this whole black ideology. And what do you mean by black, you know what I mean? And we, from all angles, from the food industry, from food, clothing, engineering, we're just trying to uplift and just show the next generation, say, yo, you don't have to go to school and do your engineering and work for like a big white corporation, but you can take your stuff, because there's a big pool of engineers that will be actually coming along. It's like, okay, cool, let's see how we can work towards funding a car program in the next couple of months, you know what I mean, with proper sales and stuff like that. We can just find ideologies and find people that can help us grow these things, you know what I mean? Because now the other thing is that we have graduates that are not high, and we have dropouts that are successful, which is kind of tricky, you know what I mean? What's the reason that people are graduating but they're not getting higher, you know what I mean? It's the students understanding that the white supremacy is controlling everything, right? So it's hard for people to get hired because it targets just, you know what I mean, gay people. At university, there's more black kids than white kids, but there's more black kids that are not hired than white kids are. So it's like, what's happening? So it's up to us to say, yo, let's start by creating these brands. Let's start by, you know, one of our friends must create like a whole, like a Unilever vibe, you know, like washing products, you know what I mean? We need people to not think about buying black clothes, about clothing and food, but let's invest in industries, because we also start with a low quality brand with consistency and people buying into it, manage to grow. So we want to implement the same strategies and everything. So we're using this collection, you know, to kind of like go the way that's really matters. You know, I don't want to just talk about it and say, yeah, 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 but I want people to be really just like, I know what I'm wearing, I know what I'm endorsing, type of thing. Yeah, so that's like kind of like break down to it.
You said a lot. So I want to know specifically about the color. Like, why did you decide to go for yellow? I mean, there must be a reason behind it.
Yeah, I mean, you know, yellow is associated with spring. Yes. You know what I mean? You know, in spring, black people come alive. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
That's when we start realizing that, oh, white spring is actually fucking with us. You know, let's do the marches. But we're like, no, let's not march. You know, the decisions we make with the money we get from work we get paid from, it'd be like you work at Styla Gang. Let's take that money and buy black. Instead of taking that money and, you know, buying some like the same things that you've done, you're still taking the money back. So it's like you're not getting paid, but the money, like, how can I say it? I'm trying to use simple terms. Like the system is not paying you. it's lending you the money because they know they're going to get it back through your consumption of international things. You know, as kids want nice shoes, they want, and we don't know because we just want to swipe, you know, but indirectly we just feel that industry and they can grow it instead of us, type of thing. So yellow was just to say, yo, it's spring, you know, and yellow's sunshine, you know, it's sunny and everything, so it's like, okay, cool. And we know that winter is not fully out because at night it's kind of cold, yeah, so that's why we use like long sleeve products. Like this is like daytime, you know, short sleeve.
Yeah.
But at night, if you don't want to wear like a yellow sweater, you know, you can wear a golf shirt, long sleeve, light fabrics. You know, you can still be as free as like wearing a t-shirt. You know what I mean?
Tell us where the people can get it.
Yeah, I mean, our store is located at Zone 6 Venue.
Yes.
You know, deep through Zone 6.
Yeah.
So if you need anything, you can also hit us up on WhatsApp, you know, everything.
The pricing and everything. Yeah,
yeah, like just go into our online platforms, the details are there. The bio of the brand just has all the details. If you need to buy, there's a number there.
Yeah.
You know, Instagram is S.G.O.D, same as Twitter, Facebook is S.G.O.D, you know, that's where you can find us. Just, you know, we're not like, we don't believe in like online stores.
Yes.
Because the black kids are not online stores vibes, they're WhatsApp vibes.
Yeah,
it's accessible, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So for us, it's like we're not following international trends, we're just focusing on trying to be like them. We're just focusing on our reality to say, yo, what's going to happen to a 14-year-old kid that stays in Bumala that doesn't have a credit card or is not familiar with online, you know, platforms and stuff like that? But no, you need to do WhatsApp because WhatsApp, everyone has it. You know, and people that see us on Instagram can be like, okay, I have it. Majority of like 80% of the black youth has WhatsApp, so that's where the market is for the black youth. You know what I mean? Not for the system, you know, because you know mostly people with money can only access online. Yeah, that's about it.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank
that
you.
Is it for Styla Gang, guys. Go and get the new line, Decolonize. Do the WhatsApp thing, get your shit together, and you know, feed them. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.